Operating an electron ionization source at 70 electron volts ensures efficient, repeatable ionization of a wide range of molecules. As a result, 70 electron volts is the standard for all commercial EI libraries. But for all of its benefits, 70 eV electron ionization may cause excessive fragmentation and loss of high mass molecular ion information unique to compound identification. Specialty techniques, such as chemical ionization, are sometimes used to preserve molecular ion information. But these approaches involve additional cost, complexity, and expertise to perform effectively. What if you could achieve enhanced molecular ion with the universal ease, simplicity, and applicability of GC-MS electron ionization? In this Innovation Minute, we will discuss low-energy EI for the Agilent 7250 GC QTOF.
Any ion source may be operated at various energy levels. But in order to achieve a decrease in fragmentation, it actually needs to be operated below 20 eV. In these conditions, a traditional ion source would have very poor sensitivity. This loss of sensitivity is addressed through our proprietary ion source technology, which is based on Agilent's high-efficiency ion source design. This source features a high-strength axial magnet, optimized lens design, and a centrode filament. This allows efficient on-axis ionization even at low electron energy levels. You can clearly see from the spectra of fatty acid metal ester an increase of relative abundance of the molecular ion that would be useful for unknown compound identifications. All this is possible with just a single parameter change. Using 70 eV, you can still get NIST library searchable spectra with low detection limits.
Enabling unknown compound identification while reducing the need for challenging techniques provides maximum productivity and utility from a powerful platform. We hope you've enjoyed this Innovation Minute. For more information on the Agilent 7250 GC QTOF mass spectrometer, please visit Agilent's website.